Okay, so let's say you have your data in Excel file format, or let's say after field survey, you have your data in Excel format and you want to convert your data from Excel format into Shapefile. So we have several approaches to achieve that, but for this tutorial, we're going to see how can we achieve that by using QGIS software. So before that, let me open my data, which is this one. As you can see, we have several columns here. So this one is the ID, the name, and whatever. But if I scroll here, you can see we have our latitude and the longitude. Okay, and not just that, we also have some other data here. But what we want to achieve is to export this data from Excel format into a shapefile format. Okay, so the first step is to make sure that I save my data into a CSV. Okay, I save my data as a CSV file format. So from here, let me click file. Of course, for now, I am using LibreOffice. So if you're using Excel, you can use the same approach. Just make sure that you save your data in CSV file format. So from here, let me select file, and then let me select save as. Then from here, I need to select the CSV file format. Of course, the name, you can change it, but for me, I'm going to maintain the same name, and then I'm going to save. So this is very important step. We saved our data in a .csv file format. Then from here, I need to open my QGIS. Of course, I'm using QGIS 3.22 by the time I'm recording this video. But if you don't have QGIS installed in your system or in your PC, just go to Google, then search QGIS download, then download and install it, QGIS, in your PC. Then from here, let me open my QGIS. This is my software. Now, what I need to do, the first step is to import my data, my CSV data, in a QGIS. Okay, is to import my CSV file in QGIS. And to achieve that, I need to go here straight to layers, and I need to select add file. Okay, add layer. So from layer, let me select add layer. Then let me select add delimited text layer. Okay, so if I select this, you can see we have this little window here. But I need to select these three dots, browse, and let me find where I saved my file, which was this one, which was the CSV file which we converted earlier. So I need to import this CSV in QGIS. So if I select open, remember you need to browse to a place where you saved your CSV file format. So if I go here, you can see we have some several fields, but the most important ones are the X and Y fields. As you can see, QGIS pull these two columns here and assign them in a respective field, which is X and Y. Therefore, I don't think if there is anything that we can change in here. So just maintain X as longitude and Y as latitude. If I scroll down, you can see here we have the geometry CRS, which is a coordinate reference system. I'm going to maintain WGS84, but if you want to change, feel free. But for now, I'm going to maintain WGS84. If I go down, you can see we have a preview of our data here. Okay, remember this one was the latitude and longitude, which is the same as this one's here. Okay, so from here, I need to add my data. Okay, so until now we have achieved to add our CSV file data in QGIS. So I need to close this and preview my data. So you can see we have some several points here, but if I right click and check the attribute table, you can see this was the same as what we had in Excel. Okay, the same. So what I need to do is to close this and find a way to export our data in a shapefile format. Okay, so if I right click this and if I go to export and select save features as, okay, then from here I need to make sure that the export format is in a ESRI shapefile. That's very important. Then I need to browse location where I want my shapefile to be saved. So if I go here, let me create a new folder and let me give it a name. Let's say this is a shapefile. Just give it any name that you want. Then I need to open this folder and give it a name. Let's say ABC a file. Then, of course, the format here is ESRI Shapefile. Then I need to save. Okay, so the coordinate reference system. So if you want to change, you can change it from here. But for me, I'm going to maintain WGS 84. But if you want to change, feel free to change from here. Okay, from here. But for me, I'm going to maintain the same coordinate reference system. Then from here, I don't think if there is anything I can change because my format is in shapefile. And this is my location. And also, this is the coordinate reference system that I want to use. Then from here, just click OK. Then let me go back to my folder. You can see this was the shapefile number 2, the folder. So this is my data. Of course, I managed to convert my data from Excel to shapefile. So these ones here are the shapefiles. So let me show you one thing. Let me disable this tool and let me select this. Remember, this was in shapefile 2. Let me select this and drag and drop. Drag and drop in QGIS. Then after that, let me close these ones. If I select, let's say this one, and let me select the attribute table. You can see we have the same data. So that is how we can export our data from, or we can convert our data from Excel file format into a shapefile file format. Again, my name is Engineer Lodrick, and this is Hydroinformatics Academy, a place where we discuss about technologies related to water supply and irrigation engineering. That being said, thank you, and I'll see you in the next tutorial.